So today I will start with the first chapter of VBA. Okay, this is a live session. So whoever is attending demo, that's fine. You just experience the training. I'll answer all your queries in the end of the session. Is that fine with you all? Okay, so let me start with it. See, the first chapter covers the introduction. How is it, you know, what is VBA? How is it introduced to MS Office applications? Why we need to use it? What is its advantage and disadvantage? All these things let's discuss today. See, VBA is an abbreviation for Visual Basic for Applications. Okay, so when you, so these things will be covered now. So it's an acronym for Visual Basic for Applications. And see, it is basically designed for all the MS Office applications that are available to us. So it could be for Excel, Word, PowerPoint, Access, Outlook. For all these things you have VBA, you can use this. But the VBA is essentially used only with MS Office applications and not with any other application. Okay. So it was first designed, you know, for Excel. So the reason is we had a lot of calculations to perform, and you know, heavy processing was done in Microsoft Excel. So that's when it was primarily introduced for it. So later on, they gradually introduced to other MS Office applications as well. And you should not be confusing it with VB. That is Standard Visual Basic. VBA is different from Standard Visual Basic. The reason is, see, Standard Visual Basic is used to develop standalone applications. When I say standalone, so you have so many different applications like Excel. So you have other gaming apps. You have Word. So these are standalone applications. Standard Visual Basic is used to develop such applications. Whereas VBA is used to just automate the task that can be performed using these applications. So for example, I take Excel. I want to automate some task that I can perform using Excel. For that, I will be using VBA. Whereas Standard Visual Basic is, you know, used to develop an entire separate software itself. You can create your own software if you know VB, Standard Visual Basic. Okay, so now that you have a lot of other you know, programming languages, popular programming languages like Python, and you know, so there are a lot of things included, AI, machine learning, Python, so R language. So these things are a separate thing altogether. So they are all used for various reasons. Again, you can use them also for automation. But only reason why we don't use them here is the cost. So you see, you don't have to separately install VBA, the Visual Basic for Application. If you have MS Office in your system working fine, you already have VBA in it. You just have to make use of it. So that's the greatest advantage of having VBA in your system. So why we use VBA? So as I said, you can use this VBA to automate repetitive tasks and routine tasks. Now, suppose you have some reports to be created. You create monthly report, weekly report, quarterly, half yearly, yearly. You have such reports to be created. And most of the time, you find the same set of data being provided. Only, you know, the rows might be different. So the fields that you use there is almost the same. You have to sit and work on it for days together to just generate the report the way you want. But if you know VBA, so you can create your own dashboards, reports, and such things by writing macros. So they will reduce your working time like anything. So to an exponential level, you can reduce your working time. And also the major advantage of using VBA is it is accessible to other users as well. So now suppose you have a high-end you know, programming language you are using at your system. You develop something from it. if you have to make it run on other system. So there needs to be some things installed on their system as well. So you don't have to worry about all such things if you use VBA, because all of them, or most of them, 99% of the people who work, using computers to get their job done, they will have MS Office installed in it. So you can easily send your files that you have worked, if you have written some macros, you have done something or some automation in it, you can send it easily to the other person. Okay. And it also reduces the burden of using formulas in Excel reports. See, if you are preparing reports, you need to provide a lot of formulas in order to see the changes in the data. If you know VBA, you could, easily get the reports done. Not that you don't use formulas, but you don't have to keep the formulas as it is. You can change it to values and you can make it very dynamic, So that also adds to reduction in file size, quick way of working on the data and these things. That is known as the turnaround time. You get your job done very quickly if you know so. And now let's say you have hundreds of worksheets and workbooks that you're working in. You would like to show only particular sheets to someone, the user, and the rest of the sheets need to be hidden, let's say. You can use VBA to get it done really quick. Okay, you don't have to go manually, give something like manually unhide, hide, and all such things, and which will be again accessible to others if they are trying to unhide it. So all these things can be done. So that's the reason why we have to choose VBA. When to use it? See, this is also very important. Nobody will recommend you to use VBA at every point of time. So there are some things that you have to look into before you choose VBA to get your job done. You first categorize in which category your work falls into. Whether it's an automation, it's a repetitive task, then use VBA because it's going to reduce your time. Extension to user interaction. See, this means you want to provide some form. You want to receive information from the user in a different way. Rather than asking them to just dump the data over there, type everything within a sheet. So you can ask them to provide information in a form. You can, prepare such interfaces using VBA. So for that, you can use VBA if you have such requirement. Doing things another way. See, this is another thing. So if you want to create some templates, which are again dynamic in nature, you want them to work in a particular way, then we are going to use VBA. So things which you can't get it done normally using Excel. So such things can be done through VBA. And also even if it is a one-time task, let's say, if it is really difficult to get the job done manually, you can always take help of VBA. Now let's say I can give you an example of comparing two different worksheets which has got 10,000 rows and let's say 150 columns. Each cell needs to be compared. So there are different ways to do it, but if you have a VBA code written for it, so it would hardly take few lines and it will give you the results in an accurate way. Rather than using any other method, VBA would be best for it. Okay, so you can use VBA for all these things. Otherwise, guys, you don't have to always choose VBA. I'm telling you this. The reason is Excel and all other MS Office applications are already very sophisticated with so many other options to make your life easier. You can go about and choose them to do those things easily if it isn't working out, or if your task falls into these three categories, then you go for VBA. Okay. And the next thing. So this is a history of VBA. So history is not my cup of tea, but still I'll just brief you. It's a story how this VBA came into existence. So as I said in the beginning, it was first developed with Microsoft Excel, so to be used with Microsoft Excel. Later, they introduced it to Project MS Office Project. So Microsoft Project is another application wherein you keep track of your project progress and your team members, what's their task progress. So these things, they do it in Microsoft Project. So they included VBA over there as well. And then it was introduced for Access. So, and all other MS Office applications in the same way. One by one, it was included. And finally, in 1998, so they gave this VBA and VBA version 6 was launched. So it has, again, a lot of modifications have been done from then on. Just give me a second, guys. So advantages, I've already told you all these advantages before. I'll just brief it to you again. You can automate almost anything in the Microsoft applications that you are doing currently. As I said, you have a task. Let's say I'll just give you a very simple example of copy pasting. So you all agree copy pasting is very easy task, but if you have to do it in a large volume, let's say you have hundreds of files to be copied and pasted into one particular workbook. So though it is easy, it's time consuming. You have to open that file, copy it, paste it. So you have to go on doing it for hundreds of files. But if you know VBA, if you write a code for it, so just you have to spare a few lines and that will get the job done for you. Okay, you can just, let it execute and you can just go have a cup of coffee and come back, your job will be done. So it's that simple if you use VBA. And the another advantage is it executes the task in exactly the same way that you perform. So as I said, I'll just come back to the same example that I gave you just now. How do you copy paste the values from a particular sheet? So you first open the workbook. You choose the sheet from where the data has to be copied. You select the data, you copy it, and you paste it in the destination file. That is where exactly you want to paste the data. And again, you will open another file, go to the sheet, copy the data, and paste it. This time you're going to paste it below the data that you had already pasted before. So it should go on like this. If you know how to write VBA, these tasks will be performed exactly in the same way. So that's the meaning of it. And it is much faster than you. Of course, see, you can copy paste almost around 150 files within 5 minutes. Max to max, if your RAM is even slower, you can consider it getting done by 10 minutes, let's say. So it's that fast. So there are tools that have been developed to reduce the working time like this. So we have developed templates as well in the previous some projects. So I can give you an example of where, the people were working on a particular report for 3 days. It came down to 3 minutes, guys. So this is a drastic change that you can see in the work, timing of your work on it. You don't have to struggle if you know VBA. And also, you need to be good at macros so that the task that is performed is without errors. See, what does this mean? You give some wrong instructions to your computer, it will behave differently. So you should always make sure your instructions are understandable by the application or the computer that you're using and it performs accordingly. So it's very essential your macros are in good shape and you have written it in a proper way. Okay, those are the advantages. So you can also use it for these things. If you have set up a macro properly, so the user need not, so some things I'm telling you, not all of them. If your macros are set up properly, so someone who doesn't know programming also can perform tasks by running a macro. Say how this is possible. Let's say you have developed a template. You just ask the user to give some input data. It could be either typing in or you could just give a file to be selected. So there are different types of inputs like this. All these things can be done by just click of a button. So a person need not know VBA programming to use a tool that you have developed in VBA. That's the beauty of it. You can ask them to just, you know, few clicks and it'll work fine if you have designed in that way. And so I told you about this, can do things that are otherwise impossible. So if there is something that you do even once, so it may not be into the category of repetitiveness, still you can opt for VBA if it is really difficult to get it done manually. This will do it for you. Yeah, this also I told you, for long time consuming tasks, you don't have to sit in front of the computer and get bored. So you can get it done. And as you know, we have the disadvantages and advantages for anything that you consider. The disadvantages of VBA are, so you need to know how to write VBA macros, of course. See, if you are to develop something of your own, you need to know how to write macros using VBA. And let's say you have got a tool which is developed by someone else to edit it or to change it according to your requirement, you need to have your own copy of the VBA programs. See, not always the code is shared to you. Okay, so it can be protected or sometimes even removed from the background. You don't get to see any code. There are such provisions that we can do so that the programs are not available to you, but the application will still work fine. So there are such things, but those tools cannot be edited. For that, you need to have your own copy of VBA. And there are many instances where VBA has not worked. So not always. It also depends on what kind of input you're providing. If you, you know, intend to provide some different input, it doesn't work always. Okay, so you should check into these things. It's not always your VBA is not going to work fine. So that's the meaning of it. And the biggest disadvantage is this one. VBA is a moving target. So when I say moving target, suppose now you're using, let's say, 2010 version of Excel or 16 or 19. Okay, so there are different versions and they keep getting updated. As and when your Microsoft applications get updated, your VBA code written in certain version may not work properly in all the versions that we have. So there might be a person who is still using 2003 version or 7. Let's say you developed a code in 2007 version. And you have used some features which are not there in 2019, let's say. So those commands or those options are no more present in this 2019 version. Then that VBA code will not run here. There will be compatibility issues. So this is the problem. Always, so a code developed in a particular version may not work. See, I am giving you may not work. It's not that it will not work. It will, provided those options and commands are still valid in the version that you are using. Okay. So as I said, you have some code developed in 2007 and that code might still work in 2016 or 19, provided all those options and commands are still valid in this version also. So then it will work. So these things you have to look into. Okay. So do you have any questions in the first chapter till now? Feel free, you can ask me any questions regarding this.
Ma'am?
Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, just a small question, ma'am. Which version of like Excel you will be using for?
We are teaching you in Office 365.
Okay, so both for the Excel course as well as the VBA part. Right?
Yes.
So like just now you mentioned the fact that like a few codes might not work properly in the older versions. So like how will we be able to overcome that drawback actually? Because as far as I know, the Office 365 is the latest version, right?
Yes, it is the latest version, Deepak. Now let me confirm you a few things before you ask me anything. Let me confirm you a few things. See, you have written a code in Office 365, let's say, which uses the slicer and timeline that is available in the latest versions. That is after 2013, you have such options present in Excel. I have written a code to automate those tasks using slicer, timeline and those things. So it is valid in 2013 version, 16, 19, Office 365. But when it is not valid, when you are going to use the same code in 2007, 10 or, below that, you understand? It's not that always your codes will not work. Provided those, for what purpose you have written the code, are those commands available in that version, then it will work. If it is not there, it will not work. As simple as that.
Okay. Though it's a very mundane question, ma'am, because most of the companies are using the versions higher than Office 2013 only. But suppose if such a situation arises in which the compatibility issue is there, so in that case, is it the case that the commands which are used earlier, a separate training will be required for working in
Not exactly, yes, Deepak. See, what happens here is only those objects need to be considered. If those options are not available and it is there in your client's place or something, let's say, always you have to remember before developing a tool for them or for your own organization, you should make sure what version of MS Office they are using. Okay. Keeping that in your purview, you have to design your tool. Okay. You are designing your tool based on that. Okay. It doesn't mean that you should always worry about, getting it advanced. Not something like that. Only if that option is not available, it's not going to work. Otherwise, the VBA codes are same. You don't have to get a separate training for 2019 version, Office 365 or 13. The codes will work provided those options are there, as I said. Those objects should be there. So as I gave you an example of slicer and timeline, they are not available in the previous versions. Before 2010, you don't get to see them. Those options are not available. But from 2013, all those options are still valid. They are there. So if a particular object or option is not there in that version, it will not pop up for you. So that command will not be accepted by your code. You understood?
Okay. Perfect. Thank you. Thank you, Juba.
Okay. Okay, let me take you to another chapter. So this was about the introduction to VBA, why we have to use, how, when we have to use, and those things. Now let me take you to VBA editor. So let me show you that using Excel screen. I'll open a blank Excel. Let me share that screen to you. See, you see a blank workbook here. Now, for this workbook, I would like to write a code, VBA macro. So you have to understand something here. When I say macro, program, procedure, all three mean the same here. You don't find any difference between them. Only thing is different terms are given. So meaning is same. When I say a macro, that is also a program and that is also a procedure. So people in different places, they use different words. That's all. Nothing to be confused here. Now to write the macros, we need an editor. for any programming language, if you are to write a program, you need an editor. So even for VBA, we have an editor in the MS Excel application. To go to that window, to go to the editor, you have to select the developer tab. Now, suppose you don't have this developer tab. How to get it? Let me show you. You have to just go and click anywhere on the ribbon, on any ribbon, just right click. You have to click on customize the ribbon. It will take you to this window. And over here, you can see all the tabs that are visible to you on your ribbon. See here, this developer tab will not be selected. If it is not visible over there, it will not be selected. You just have to choose this and say OK. And then it will appear here. So in the developer tab, you have got an option here, Visual Basic. You need to select that. It will take you to the editor like this. So there is a shortcut as well. You can use Alt F11. Alt F11. Okay. If you use that, you can use it to go back to Excel sheet or get back to the editor. You can switch between them. Let me share the screen to you. See, you can switch like this. Alt F11. It'll take me to Excel. Alt F11. It'll again get me back to the editor. So this is your VBA editor. We also call it VBE, Visual Basic Editor. Okay. So as soon as you open it, so this is how it looks actually. And you see a lot of menu bars here. So these menu bars are used for various reasons. Okay, to insert something, how to format your code, debug, run. So there are a lot of options here. Okay. And you also have some shortcuts that icons will be present here to look at it. Now in the editor, if you use Control R, that's the shortcut. You can also go to View tab here. See the View menu bar. You can go here and click on this Project Explorer. So if you select this, this window will appear. See, this is the main window to know what all things are available to us in the workbook that we are working on. As soon as you see this Project Explorer, you can observe here VBA Project Book 1. Book 1 is the name of our workbook. I have not saved it. I have not given any name to it. So it displays as Book 1. And with this nested part, so within this project, what all are there? So we have Microsoft Excel objects. All these are objects that you see here. So we have only one sheet and we have another workbook module. So I'll explain you in detail regarding the modules later. But you will be able to see all these things, all the objects related to this particular workbook over here in the Project Explorer. This window is known as Project Explorer. Now let me go back. I will add another sheet, another sheet, another sheet. So again, get back to VB Editor. See, you can see all those sheets over here as well. So whatever, however many number of sheets you have in this workbook, whether they are hidden or visible, doesn't mind, all of them will be listed here. It will be visible over here. Okay, so these are all the Excel objects and it will be displayed. Not only this, if you have used some modules, as I said, I'll be explaining you regarding the modules in the later section. So all those modules will also be displayed here under this project. And keep in mind, this VB editor is common to all open workbooks. Now when I say that, now let's say I would add another, I'll just open another workbook. You see, book 2, I opened this. Now let me get back to VB editor. Can you see this book 2, VBA project book 2? So you can keep 100 files open for all those. This is the common window. Don't assume you get to see a different editor for every Excel workbook that you are using. it is a common thing. So this place is common to all workbooks on which you are using currently to develop your project. Okay, so you see this window, and within this you can see the different workbooks that are kept open. For all those open workbooks, you can see here. Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, like here we can see the sheet 1, sheet 2, these are all objects.
Yeah.
Below them it's mentioned this workbook.
Yes.
So this workbook, which is displayed adjacent to this workbook, it's different as compared to the icon which is shown with the other sheets actually.
Exactly.
This workbook is also an object, or it's a module, or what exactly?
See, all these are objects as well as modules. I'll explain to you. So let me go one by one.
In that case, why is the icon for this workbook different, ma'am, than compared to sheet 1?
See, this is an object as well. I'll tell you, VBA is an object-oriented programming language. Everything over here that you see in MS Excel application, they're all considered as objects only, including your Excel application. Your Excel application is also an object, and your workbook is also an object. Sheets are objects, cells within that are objects, and whatever you embed on those sheets, so like shapes, charts, images, all these are also objects, okay? Just to differentiate, this is a different object and this is a different object, you get to see different icons here. So we'll come to this section when I teach you what are the different types of modules that are available to us in VBA. Okay, so these are used for a different purpose. That's the reason they have different icons here, to identify it in a different way.
You get so that? Every object can have modules, right? Sheet 1 also can have module, and this workbook also can have module, right?
No. They are all objects, but not every object has got a module here. Okay, only specific objects have modules. Like sheets, this workbook, your application, only these have modules. And you have also got modules like general module and user form module, class module. So I don't want to hop around, Deepak. Let's go one by one. You will understand it.
Okay,
because if you miss the flow, you will not understand again. So it will get confused. So I will take you to all those things, all those topics. You just have some patience to go through this in the flow. Okay, you will understand.
I will do. Thank you.
Okay. Guys, you can express your doubts directly rather than chatting, because Ali, I will come to that. As I said, it is there in the further chapters. You can express your doubts by unmuting yourselves. Okay. I'll come to the modules later. What is module? How many different types of modules are there? I'll not be able to open the chat screen while teaching. So I expect you to express your doubts unmuting yourselves. So this is Project Explorer. As I said, you get to see all different types of modules, objects, everything listed here. Okay. Next. There is another window, F4. So you can see here, press F4, you will see properties window. Or you could also go to view and you can just click on this properties window over here. When you click on it, you get to see this window. So only for few things, see like sheet, this workbook, you get to see some properties here. You can see this name of the sheet, whether these page breaks are displayed, auto filters are enabled or not. So all these things, whether the sheet is visible or hidden, you can see certain properties of that object in the properties window. So this window can also be used to see different, controls we insert in a user form. So when you create a form, you can provide this text box, drop down, buttons, and these things. For that also, you'll get to see properties over here. Okay. So every object that we have in VBA, every object, it has got some properties, methods, and events. It's a part of it. See, these are the skeletal structure of your VBA. Without these, the VBA would not exist. So as I said, VBA is an object-oriented programming language. It will consider all those things that are available to us over here as objects. Now, as I said, your Excel application is an object, workbook, worksheet, cells, charts, images, shapes, all these things are objects. And each of them have their own set of properties, methods, and events. Now, when I say properties, anything that you can use to describe that object, you can take it as a property. Now, let me tell you here, we have a cell. Now, if I type anything over here, this is the content of it. That's a property of that cell. Again, I say H9. It's the address. So I use it to describe this object. So that also becomes a property. Now, if I have given some color, text color, border. So there are so many things that you can consider as properties of a cell. Now, I'm just taking one example. Cell is an object, and whatever I use to describe that cell, all those become the properties of it. What are methods? Now, I can delete the cell, clear the contents of it, copy it, paste it elsewhere, insert, delete. So there are so many things, that action that you can perform on that object. So then it is considered as method. Methods are actions that you perform on it. Okay. Then what are events? Events are, again, related to these objects. There are some triggers like double click, selection, right click. See, all these become events of it. See, events are those which trigger other macros that you have written specifically for them. And again, I'll discuss all these things in worksheet or workbook module that we are going to write. See, events are any trigger. So like, as I said, double click, right click. So selection, activate, deactivate, all these will become the events. So leave apart events as of now. Just concentrate on properties and methods. So as I said, now if there is a content within that cell, that is a property. If there is a cell border to it, that is also a property. Cell color, font color, you know, address of that cell, row number, column number, everything that I use to describe that cell will become the property. That's the property of it. Okay. Methods are something that you can perform on that object. As I said, you can insert a cell, delete, copy, paste. All these are known as methods. Okay. Are you all clear with it till here? Till here, are you clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Over here, we have object model. This is another important aspect that you have to understand in order to write your programs. See, object model is a way to address the object. How exactly you're going to use that in the macros? What should be given first? See, just like you have an address. Let's say someone, your friend, who's coming from foreign. For not exactly now, they have all shut it down. But let's say you want to guide the person who is coming from a different country. So you'll first say you'll have to come down, land in India, and whichever state you are in, whichever city you are in, and within that city, in which area, which street, which house number, you have to provide this detailed address. Only then the person will reach you. In the same manner, to write a program, you are going to access an object. Now suppose, I will give you an example. I want to copy paste a cell. In order to copy paste, I should say, in which application I'm writing this? which workbook, what is the sheet name, what is the cell address that I have to copy. Once I give this complete address, then I'll say what to do with that object. So object model is going to describe that. Now let me show you what is an object. I've already told you all these objects that contain data, properties and methods. If you consider an object, it has got properties and methods. Say if suppose you can take a general example as well. You have a mobile. Even that has got properties and methods. See your mobile, you'll say what model it is, which company is it, like iPhone, so which version it is, what are the features in it. All these things will become its properties. So what are methods? So you can make a call, check your mails, WhatsApp. So many other things that you can perform with that object are all known as methods. So as I said, every object contains these things, properties, methods, and events. Object model, see, I told you now, it is a hierarchy. It's a complete address to that object. It's a large hierarchy of all the objects in every application used in VBA. Considering Excel, I told you, first the Excel application has to be considered. Then, let me show you this. See, this is the object hierarchy. We call it object hierarchy. This hierarchy needs to be followed in your programming language. Only then you will be able to write the programs. You have to follow the hierarchy like this. See, application. So we are using Excel, so Excel is our application. If you are using Word, again, the hierarchy will differ because there the objects are different. See, if I say Excel, Excel application has got workbook. One file instance is known as workbook here. In Excel application, if you open a file, that's a workbook. So after application, workbook comes into picture. Application is the one which is containing all these things. It's a bigger container. So within application, you have workbook. You can have n number of workbooks. All that comes under this. Next, within workbook, again, you can have any number of worksheets. So you have that below this. Next, within worksheet, you might have shapes. Range is nothing but the cells, guys. So don't get confused. In VBA, even a single cell is known as range. Okay, range is just a collection of cells or a single cell as well. So range, so you have charts, so many more like this. Okay, so we have considered these three. Within worksheet, all these can be present. And if I choose a cell range, these are the things that we can use to write the code, like its font, border, interior is the cell color. If I'm selecting a cell, I can consider its border, font, interior, value, all these things. So this is the hierarchy you need to follow if you are using Excel application. Say if you are using PowerPoint, let's say you are using VBA to write a macro for PowerPoint, then the object hierarchy will differ altogether. So there you will choose at the topmost of the hierarchy, you will see PowerPoint application. So within the PowerPoint application, we have presentations, and within presentation, you have slides, and slides again can contain shapes, paragraph, text or text boxes, all these things, images, so placeholders. So there are so many things, again, the content of that slide. So depending on what application you are using to write macros, the object hierarchy will change accordingly. Okay, so this is a very important topic of the VBA macros. So you need, it is utmost important to understand the object hierarchy. Only then we can understand the programs properly, why we are using this in this manner. So next, properties. So as I said, they are the characteristic attributes or description to that object. So you can describe them with something like their color, shape, size, then all that becomes their property. So again, you have two types of properties, read-write, read-only. Read-write is one such property which you can make changes to it. So here they have used this read write property. They have given the examples of read write property wherein a name of the sheet is considered. If I have to change the name of the sheet, yeah, I will be able to do so. So that is the read write example. I can change the property by just giving a value to it. So there are some properties like this which take different values. So they are known as read write properties. So then what is read only? So here they have used the text. So you could also take the state of it. So here text property, there is something known as text property of a cell. It just provides the formatted appearance of a value in a cell. But you cannot change the value of that cell using this property. So the meaning of this is, let's say I have a number given in a cell and which is formatted with a dollar symbol, two decimal places, all these things. I want the exact appearance of that number, the way it is. Okay? More than the value, I'm trying to get the appearance of that value. Then I'm going to use this text property. But it doesn't allow you to change the value of that cell. So for that, you can use it. Okay? So method is an action performed. Yes, please tell me.
Can you give an example?
Like?
What are the property you told me that?
I just gave you now.
This kind of text. I didn't understand that.
Okay. While writing, so when we start writing the programs, I'll give you a clear example of it. Currently, you will be not understanding why we have used these things. Okay. When we start writing the programs, you will definitely understand it. So there are few things which I can't reveal it right now because you will not understand it unless and until so things go in the flow. Okay. So make note of these things. We will cover it in the further chapters. Okay, so method, as I said, it's an action performed by an object. You can select, copy, paste. All these things are considered as methods. Next, events. So this also I explained to you. These are actions performed or occurrences which trigger a VBA code or macro. So let's say you write a macro to be run whenever a particular cell is double clicked or whenever a sheet is opened. So that macro should run immediately, or when you change the cell value, the macro should run immediately. So these things are known as events which trigger another macro, or you can just invoke that, you know, by performing that action, just like double click, right click. These things are also known as events. So they have given examples over here. Opening, closing, activating, deactivating, all these are considered as events. So events you don't get to see in the early stages of your programming. Okay. Once we are done with all our simple codes, simple VBA codes, we'll be working on specific modules like this workbook or worksheet module. That is when the events comes into picture. Otherwise, in your very general macros, we don't get to use this events. So that is one thing. And do you have any questions regarding this topic, object model?